Hello and welcome back. My name is Rosalind. This is my Let's Play of Dragon Quest XI. On the last episode, we kind of got absorbed into this world that's the world of the wall painting. That seems to be, a monster of some sort. The painting on the wall was absorbing people and making them part of her painting of herself. We had to continue figuring out how not only how to get out of here, but find little girl Mel, who we're trying to help find her parents, but she kind of disappeared on us, so we think she may be in here. That's kind of where we're at. That was a crit there just now. Veronica leveled up. Make sure I fight at least one of every enemy. Okay, let's stop attacking the hero, please. Man. This bit of move is just like a chance of man instant death. There. That is a giant chest. That is a huge chest. I have a feeling this is like a mimic of some sort. Yep. A Giga Mimic. I guess that was pretty obvious, but try to use this, see if it hits. I've tried using it numerous times, I've never actually gotten it to hit. Leveled up and learned Behoimu. There's a really, really large heal. We have small heal, medium heal, really large heal, resurrection, but chance to fail. Fairy necklace, huh? Okay. HP and MP plus 10, defense plus 3, and it reduces the amount of MP that can be stolen from you by 10%. Thank you. crit. Very nice crit. Martina leveled up. She currently has 30 skill points, but... Sanya leveled up as well. She has 30 skill points, but I'm not sure if it's enough to get... a skill and after. There they are. I wonder if it'll let me go over here without triggering. Nope. I was hoping it'd let me go off to the right there without triggering a cutscene. So, she was going on about how she had a really bad feeling, and I think we figured out what that bad feeling is. Yeah, so it looks like the reason... looks like this is probably what's, haunting the painting. And, is absorbing people into the painting, basically for food for this monster. Okay. Put go the mark on our arm there. Looks like a grave. It's not really a grave, actually. It's like it's just a stone that has writing on it. It's left by the person who first found this wall, looks like. So basically what he's saying is, by accident, on the side of the village, he found this wall paint, this strange wall painting, that's from the ancient, country of, Puachat? Yeah. And I guess it, was destroyed only hundreds of years ago. He says it should have been a good thing, as you know, people would come flock to the village and it would bring prosperity. But that was wrong. The wall painting is cursed by evil, basically. So basically, it leads, in order to absorb people. It preys on their pleasures in life to bring them to it, in which case it then absorbs them. And for people who don't have a lot of, they don't have a desire for much in life, like they're not like a very, they're not a very greedy person, or they're not lustful for something, the wall then appears as a little girl in order to basically appeal to their good side and to try to lure them in. So I think we found out who Mel is. A place we can go, so maybe we can go back there eventually. For now, I think this is going to take us back out through that cut in the wall we saw before. Yeah, now she's saying the same thing. Looks like we made it back. Yeah. Just making the recommendation that we need to basically inform everyone about the truth about this wall painting. More than that, I want the key that's on it. Look who it is. Oh, so this old man, he was just passing by, but he had heard rumors of the wall. And now Mel here is basically saying, she's not lying. When she saw the painting on the wall, her sickness was healed. And now Sylvia is saying, the one who's gonna, you know, become healthy and all good and whatnot is not the the old man, but actually the monster inside the wall. Obviously, she's surprised that we made it out. And Sydney's asking for her to stop doing that, stop leading people into the wall, and to release who she's already captured. She's like, you know, there's no way I'm going to release those people I've already captured. And this power was given to me by, you know, this power was given to me by that one the one guy. She's obviously talking about the demon lord here. She received her power, and you know, she can't bow down to humans. Now she's telling us to come back to her world, and instead of attacking us with a little plant thing, she'll greet us herself. And that person that she was talking about, obviously, Ro, just asked like who that was. I mean, I think it's pretty obvious who she's talking about and she received her power from. We gotta head back. And just in case, I'm gonna go ahead and save here. Sorry, in that last little section, I kind of had a little brain fart when trying to convert the Japanese into English in my head. Okay, well, that's where I'm going to stop for this episode. And the next episode, we will... I'm basically just going to avoid the enemies. We're going to make a beeline for the boss of this dungeon. And see if we can't we'll figure out maybe we get an orb from all this, or at least get some clues to where the next orb is that we need, and maybe that key that was going on here will become ours, and we can finally open some of those doors around the world that have been locked. We'll have to wait for next time. So if you're enjoying the series, please leave a like. If you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, let me know in the comment section below. And if you haven't done so already, please subscribe. It really does help. I'll see you next time.